everyone, it's me Anushka. Welcome back to another video. I previously put up a video regarding my journey to the National Institute of Fashion Technology and I received a really good response in that. And ever since I put up that video, I have been getting a lot of questions regarding the NIFT entrance examination, which is supposed to take place soon in January. I put up a poll if I should do a NIFT entrance examination Q&A where I can possibly give my answers to all the common questions that I have been getting regarding it and also clear some doubts that you all have regarding the examination. So finally, here's the video and I hope you like it. And without any further ado, let's get started. So I'm going to be reading out the questions from here. The first question is, do I need to be very good at sketching? How are your sketching skills? To be very honest, my sketching skills are not very nice or very artistic. My sketches and artworks are very basic. What really matters is your concept. Your concept should be really out of the box, creative and functional at the same time. And again, you should be able to put up and portray your concepts in the best way possible through your artworks, and in that sense, make sure that your sketches are really neat, clean and on point. Ensure that your line quality is very good, and I think that's all that matters. Practice daily your sketching skills. Need not be very artistic or something like that. If you feel your sketching skills are not on point, practice compositions. I think they are very helpful. Next question is, what should be the mindset before venturing into this world? Why think out of the box? So according to me, your mindset should be very clear before venturing into a world like this. The fashion industry, as we all know, is very competitive. So before venturing into this industry, you must know what you want to do. To start off, you must be very clear about the course that you want to take up and you must prepare in accordance to that. And about the second part of the question, which is why think out of the box. See, fashion is a field which is all about creation and expression, and it is something that helps you stand out of the rest and create a statement of your own. So in order to stand out from the rest, you need to be very unique in your ideas and concepts, and in order to do that, you must always think out of the box. Next question, have you taken any other tuitions before NIFT entrance? Yes, I did. I went to BRDS, that is Banwar Rathore Design Studio in Kolkata, and I have spoken about it a lot in my previous video. If you haven't watched it yet, please make sure to watch it right here. I want to know how you solved the last year question paper, what you made in second and third question. So as much as I recall, the question, the second question was regarding a bag design, and the one that I opted for was a shopping bag design. So I divided the space, the drawing space, into two halves, and in the upper half I made a full front view of the bag, and in the lower half I made sketches of the bag from different angles, and I wrote a small explanation beside it in order to explain that what am I trying to show through that. I made the interior view of the bag. I also wrote about the functionality that I was trying to add. Overall, I tried to keep the design not just aesthetic but also functional, and I also explained the entire concept in the writing space that was given right there. Talking about the third question, it was about making a geometric shape in order to represent your personality, and you had to write a tagline for it. So this is very interesting. I had only 15 minutes left for this question and I was like, I have to do it fast or else I'm never going to complete this paper. So I just drew a circle and then I used different colors, and all of those colors were moving towards the center point. And the tagline that I used for this artwork of mine was dimensional yet determined. So I used different colors in order to depict my dimensional personality, but all of those colors moving towards the center point reflected that no matter how dimensional traits I have got, I am very determined to a particular thing. I am very focused, and this is all that I tried to portray through that artwork, and I think it worked in my favor. What all subjects are taught in NIFT? Which is your favorite subject? So I just completed my first semester in NIFT Mumbai, and the subjects that we had was drawing, design fundamentals, digital design and communication, and fashion basics. And we have general electives as well, which change every 6 months, and for that I had personality development and modeling. And well, my favorite subject was fashion basics because it is all about fashion and I got to write about fashion a lot, which I really enjoy doing, and you must know that through my blog. Are questions asked repeatedly in NIFT? No, they are not. The patterns remain similar to some extent, but the questions do not. In cat portion, can I use markers or brush pens for coloring? Are there questions on both sides of a single sheet of paper? Yes, there are questions on both sides of the paper. And no, you should not use markers or brush pens because they tend to stain the paper, and so there are huge chances that your artwork can get ruined. Try and stick to dry mediums like pencil colors. How many hours a day should I study? Let me tell all of you guys one thing. Time does not really matter. I get a lot of questions like, how many hours a day should I study? Is 1 month enough for preparing for the examination? And well, let me tell you that time does not matter. If you are studying for 1 hour a day, and in that 1 hour you are studying with all your concentration and you are putting in all your efforts, I think that 1 hour is enough. You as an individual should know that what works best for you. If you feel that studying all day is good for you, get good enough. And if you feel that studying 1 hour a day is good for you, then that's good enough as well. What kind of composition should I practice, and do we need perspective? I think perspective is a very important element when it comes to sketching, so practice perspective a lot. Moving on to compositions, I think any kind of composition is good enough to help you improve your sketching skills. Be it a bus stand or a railway station, and well, for this you can refer to the previous year question papers or sample question papers, then you'll get an idea about what kind of compositions are usually preferred. Is it good to take a draw? Again, I have spoken about it so much in my previous video, and I think you should watch it. Take a drop only if you feel that you can use the time that is available to you for the best and become a better version of yourself. What is the environment there? The environment in NIFT is amazing. You can be as creative and as expressive about your individuality and fashion preferences, and nobody is going to judge you for it. What is the minimum percentage you need in order to gain admission? In order to clear the first phase, I think you need to have marks above 50, and in case if you clear it, you sit for the situation test. Every other individual who clears the first phase and sits for the situation test gets a rank, and it is depending upon the rank that you get admission into NIFT. How is the faculty? Well, again, the faculty is very nice. They are very helpful, very understanding, and well, very talented. How are the placements? It's National Institute of Fashion Technology. It is one of the best fashion institutes in India today, and so it has got amazing placements. You can check out NIFT's official website and you'll get a clear view regarding which companies come to NIFT for placements and campus. How to clear the examination? Through hard work, through your unique concepts and your dedication. How to prepare maths? Maths is something that I'm not very good at, and I know that a lot of people do not like maths, but what I would like to advise is that do not leave out the portion. It is one of those portions which will help you score a lot, so practice as much as you can. Refer to a lot of sample papers and keep on practicing. We get centers according to the marks we have scored, or can we choose any center? You get your centers according to your rank. You get to choose from the centers and the courses that are available when your turn comes during the counseling. Best book. I don't know if it is the best, but I mainly refer to Arihant's book for NIFT entrance examination, and I also refer to the study material that was given to me from BRDS. I will put up the links to some books that are preferred for the exam preparation, and you can check it out there. How to behave and prepare for group discussion, personal interview, like dress code and stuff. I think GD and PI are exam parameters for only master students, and talking about the dress code and stuff, I think you should keep it formal. I do not have a very good idea regarding it because again, it is for the master's people and I am doing an undergraduate course. I want to go to NIFT Mumbai. Which rank does it require? In case if you want fashion design or fashion communication in NIFT Mumbai, I think you should have a rank below 80 or 70 in case if you belong to the general category. And if you want some other courses in NIFT Mumbai, I think your rank should be below 200 or 150 at least. we don't have coaching available here in my city. What do I do? Coaching was not available in my city as well, so I moved to Kolkata and stayed there for a year. But if you don't want to move out to another city, I think you can always prepare on your own. For the CAT portion, practice sketching daily and as much as you can. Practice a lot of human figures, compositions, perspective drawings and so on. And for the GAT portion, you get a lot of books to prepare from. You can check out the list that I put up in the description box below. And you can have a look at them and prepare on your own. And I think if you're very dedicated, hardworking and focused, you'll do just well even if you don't take coaching. So I think I have answered all the questions and I hope that my answers were beneficial to some extent. In case if you have any more questions, feel free to ask them in the comment section below, or you can always DM me on my social media. I will come up with another video if it's required. Thank you for watching this video, and until next time, bye!